The virtues of push feed versus controlled feed are a subject that is of long-standing debate in some parts of the firearms community. I will be using dummy cartridges for the duration of this video, for obvious reasons. In a push feed action, the bolt simply pushes the cartridge out of the magazine and up into the chamber. However, it does not actively take control of the cartridge. So at this point, once the cartridge has been pushed free of the magazine feed lips, if the bolt is retracted, there's nothing to hold the cartridge in position. The cartridge doesn't actually become locked under the bolt's extractor until the bolt handle is locked into place. On a controlled feed action, however, the cartridge is always either directly controlled by the magazine of the rifle or by the extractor. As soon as the bolt pushes the cartridge far enough forward to clear the magazine feed lips, like that, the cartridge lifts up underneath the extractor, and if the bolt is pulled back at this point, the cartridge is pulled back with it. There is really only one downside to a push feed action, and that is if the cartridge is partially chambered, i.e. it's out of the magazine, and then the bolt is pulled back prematurely, the bolt can come back and instigate a double feed malfunction, like so. In actual practice, this is relatively uncommon. However, it can potentially happen. With a controlled feed action, it cannot. If the bolt is pulled back before being locked, it pulls the top cartridge out with it and has to eject it before it can push the next cartridge into the action. There is one other factor to consider, however, and that is the ejector. Most push feed actions use a plunger ejector like this. This plunger is constantly applying pressure to the cartridge case, and as soon as the case is ejected far enough out of the action to clear the ejection port, the case will eject out of the rifle. A controlled feed action has the ejector physically mounted in the receiver behind the magazine, and so where a push feed would have ejected the cartridge case at this point, a controlled feed has to be pulled all the way back to the end of travel. What this means in practice is that a push feed has a shorter bolt throw, which means faster firing. In practice, neither system is really superior or inferior to the other. The pros and cons between them are really quite subtle, and for the vast majority of shooters will never be an issue one way or the other. In fact, in modern military bolt-action sniper rifles, controlled feed has not been used for some time, nor is it particularly sought after in modern bolt-action rifle competition circles. In my opinion, when one is shopping for a bolt-action rifle, the difference between a push feed and a controlled feed system is really not of any substantial importance. This is Ian McCollum for ForgottenWeapons.com. Hopefully you learned something useful today about push feed versus controlled feed. Thanks for watching.